Hi, my people, people of Africa, people of the world, people of Nigeria. I'm Eddie. I'm just a guy who wonders. I wonder about stuff. I'm just very curious about the world. And here's my channel. Welcome to my channel. If you like this video, hit like, drop comments, whatever you want to do. And subscribe. Subscribe if you want. I can't tell you what to do. Now, without further ado, let's just get into the video. So today's video is something very important to me, very important to us, to people, to us as humans. They are the problems facing science and innovation in Africa. I put five of them together. So five problems facing innovation and science in Africa and Nigeria specifically, because I'm going to speak from an anecdotal perspective. Let's get into it. There is an immense lack of interest in science due to its perceived esoteric nature. Esoteric meaning, it's very specialized. Like, you have to be very smart to be in science classes. You know, you have to be, like, when I was in secondary school, like, it was the smart kids went to science class. I mean, that's how it is. I mean, you guys might not agree, but that's everybody that went to school in Nigeria knows this as a fact, right? And that is a very, very wrong misconception, because there are so many non-sciences, so many people that didn't focus on science, that were not science teachers or science students or whatever, that invented so many, that did so many great things for science and to propagate the human civilization, to propagate mankind, right? Steve Jobs was not a scientist, right? Leonardo da Vinci was not a scientist. And we know what those two did. Alexander Graham Bell was not a scientist, and he invented the telephone. Henry Ford, the inventor of the assembly line and industrialization in the world, was not a scientist. You know, so it's like Benjamin Franklin was not a scientist. So it's like you don't have to be in science classes to feel like you have to think scientifically. No, that is a very, very huge misconception, and I really wish that was taken away, you know. But we're talking about problems now. Let's not. We'll get solutions later. Number two, to keep this as terse as possible, there's a shortage of skilled professionals. You know, there's a shortage of, like, just connecting to the first point, because of people's lack of interest in scientific subjects and, you know, the matters of science, the thinking of science, there is a shortage of people who want to do science, and that causes a certain kind of stigma. I mean, you must have seen it online. You must have seen tweets online mocking some jobs. I saw a tweet like last year, very recently, mocking, saying all sorts of things about some specific university courses, like, don't do this course, don't do physics, don't do geology, don't do archaeology, don't do chemistry. It's now stereotypical that those courses are a waste of your time in Nigeria, and that is detrimental to our collective mind as a people. It is highly detrimental. How do you think medicine were invented? Like, how do you think things were discovered if you don't do chemistry? You know, how we shouldn't propagate that kind of mindset. You know, that is a very, very big problem, and that causes a deficit in specialists and people who are actually in the fields, who actually, like, make it forward to be able to do stuff. I tried to find that tweet, but I forgot the guy's username who tweeted it, but I'm sure most of you or some of you who watch this video must have seen tweets or TikToks that talk about, oh, don't do this, don't do this course, don't do this course, it's a waste of your time. No, it's not. I promise you, it's not. Third point, there is a continued ignorance of scientific thinking due to the overwhelming religious and cultural dogmas that have been with us since we became you know, independent thinkers by ourselves since we became on our own. And okay, I'm not going to get into like colonization and whatever and whatnot, but since we became independent to think for ourselves, we've stuck to these dogmas, you know, that we don't even like, we don't want to grow out of them, even though the times are moving so fast. The people that brought these dogmas to us have moved on so fast, you know, and we've even in, like we now realize there's overwhelming evidence to support science, to support the ways of scientific thinking and mathematical thinking and whatnot. And still, it's not enough. Just because we feel like, oh, okay, science does not supersede my belief, you know, or what I've been taught from childhood, you know. And I strongly believe that if we did truly apply the scientific method and scientific thinking, all these dogmas would be a thing of the past. Like, I'm pretty sure of that. That's one of the most significant problems, if not the most significant. Fourth point, there is a lack of funding, you know, to build and construct, you know, these needed infrastructure like research labs and whatnot, tech hubs and stuff, you know, to help, you know, further scientific research in Africa. There's like zero budget for real science, to do real science and do research, you know. I don't have the statistics, but I'm pretty certain Nigeria probably has one of the highest concentration of church buildings in the world. Like that's probably a fact, right? Like, imagine if half of those were like research labs doing active research, you know, investigating stuff, asking questions, trying to figure stuff out. There are so many fresh ideas. I see on the internet, like sometimes, like some guy in some states invents a way to convert something to energy. Someone does this, someone does that, someone does this. Where those people go viral for a day, and then you never hear of them again. Like, why is the government not employing them? Why is the government not training them? Why is the government not collaborating with them and pushing them to, you know, commercialize those ideas and help the economy grow? So it's like, it's really mind-boggling, you know. These are very, very serious issues. Like, these are extremely important issues. And finally, there is a lack of collaboration and networking opportunities. Like, it's hard enough to even find scientists or scientific thinkers in Africa or in Nigeria. Talk more of where or how to collaborate, or events or places where you meet them, or there's probably maybe just like that I can think of. Maybe probably there's a Nigerian bank that does like a tech thing every year, maybe a tech week, and that's just part of like a line, because they do a fashion week, they do a music week, so it's like one of those, it's just one of those things. Meanwhile, this is the growth of our species as a people, you know. So it's like, it's wild to me that these things are not being prioritized and, you know, taken more seriously. I know that we can do better, and I know that there are a lot of bright minds in Africa, and just in Nigeria alone. I'm going to speak for myself. Like, there's so many bright people that want to express themselves, and it's just, there are no platforms, nobody listens. The professors, based on the dogmas, most of the professors you're going to meet in the universities are usually religious, or like it's almost canon for like an older university official to be a pastor these days. And tell me, how does a pastor want to, how would a pastor hammer home the idea of evolution? A pastor cannot believe in evolution and the creation story. It's not, those two things are mutually exclusive, you know. They're completely mutually exclusive. Many of our leaders, many of our teachers, will reject the idea of evolution, like outright. And they are science teachers in Nigeria. So it's like, it's really wild to me. These are some of the problems. Check out my next video to see some of the ideas that I think might help, you know, mitigate these problems, that might help solve these problems and help us innovate better and, like, you know, grow as a people. It's 2023, people. See you in the next video. Thank you for watching my video. Peace out.